issues which come under the terms of the Public Utility Holding Company Act of 1935. Actually, it appears to be doing its best, by various pressures, to discourage and even prevent the more grossly inequitable offerings. But it is essential that the public recognize that the Commission's powers in this respect are severely limited and that only a skeptical analysis by the intending buyer can assure him against exploitation. Promotional activities are attracted especially to any